Nigeria's last finance minister, Ngozi Okonjo-Iweala, warned before she, just before she left office, that the specter of Boko Haram insurgency in the Nigeria's northeast back then will cost the economy negative 0.5%. That was back then. We haven't seen any further revision of that figure from the current administration. But everyone seems to have an idea how much damage this insurgency, all the way from that corridor coming down to Nigeria's critical food basket of northeast, now spreading almost on a daily basis across the country's middle belt. Of course, Benue State is one of those so-called the breadbasket of the nation. Now it's now the country's blood basket, with hundreds of lives being taken out of farmers, men, women, and children who are looking for a daily living. And that's what we got, a lot of what are called watermelon and a few other sweet things that I enjoy on a daily basis. But the FDC team is warning we could face very serious problem in terms of agri production and prices very soon if we don't take care of this violence and problem of insecurity within that corridor. Bolanle Lutosin is back here from Financial Derivatives Company. She was here on Tuesday, and we spent more time talking about having the next cup of coffee. Today, there is no coffee, not even for me, because I'm upset with the state of insecurity. Good morning.
Morning.
Are you upset?
Well, yes. Yes, I am. When it comes to, you know, attacks like this, crisis within the north, and, you know, a significant portion of our agricultural produce comes from that area, it calls to concern in the sense that, you know, if there's civil unrest in those areas, then it would affect our production. And once production is affected, or production of some of these agricultural produce is affected, then the prices tend to, you know, spike up. Because
my watermelon, my mango, and my onions, and what else? I enjoy some Highland tea as well,
yeah,
from around Taraba and what have you. And that tea could also be impacted.
Yeah, of course. Like, if you do not, you know, take advantage of, you know, the situation at this moment, then it spirals down to the way Boko Haram actually was, you know, affected, and also affected some parts of the, you know, states around the country. So at this point, if the government is not focusing on, you know, the crisis within these areas, then we'll obviously see prices, you know, spike up in the nearest future. And if they do, then obviously economic growth and all the things that we've tried to achieve so far would be undermined. So those are the aspects that we see that we should call for warning for the government to, you know, make due sense of what's going on.
Your team at FDC have sat down together, and you think this is one burning economic issue for this administration to focus on very quickly, because all of us are going to pay for it.
Yeah, of course.
I want my smoothies.
Of course. And it also comes down to the consumer confidence index that the CBN released. Consumer confidence index, unlike the business confidence index, actually fell to -6.4%. So if it also shows that, you know, this agricultural crisis that we're seeing in some parts of Nigeria also feeds into the consumer confidence. So crying out loud, most individuals in Nigeria, you ask them questions, they're like, how do you feel about the state of the economy, where the economy is headed to? They only complain about prices of goods, prices of, you know, electricity, house rents, medical care, and all that.
It's the basic things of life, isn't it?
Exactly.
These are called the basics. I go to my 12th, or I go to the market in Mararaba, just near Abuja. And all folks want is what happens to the price of yam, tomato, indigenous, whatever, and carrots, what have you. And they are becoming increasingly very difficult. And folks are beginning, do we have any feel that the folks who plant and grow these things, men, women, and children, in Northeast, all the way to the next central, are getting killed on a daily basis? And I use the word murdered. It's murder, really.
It's a very difficult situation to, you know, place your fingers on. It's like, why, what is causing the civil unrest in those areas? So the government at this point should focus more on dealing with those kinds of issues compared to, you know, increasing debt within the country. If, like the IMF warned as well, if they focus more on building the economy strong enough to withstand buffers like that, strong enough to withstand shocks like this, then we'll have a better chance of moving forward, you know, creating a sustainable development, you know, situation. So at this point, you know, all we just talk about is that obviously we can't do anything about it. The government is the only person or the only institution that can actually do, you know, make solutions.
That will have to deal with it.
Exactly.
When business, when consumer, there's a difference between business confidence. We'll try to break it down a little bit. Business confidence, in my mind, speaks to business managers, entrepreneurs, purchasing managers, sales managers, their outlook on, well, I think we'll make more sales, I think I'll produce more bottles of soft drink, whatever it is, or produce more loaves of bread.
Yeah.
But when we talk about consumer confidence, that's the man on the sidewalk, the man on the street.
Yeah, and if you look at progress so far within Nigeria, we've seen exchange rate sustainability, we've seen, or stability rather, we've seen, you know, oil prices ramp up and all that. Those major positive aspects of the economy are directly impacting businesses and not necessarily the consumers at this point. Initially, you have a multiplier, or if it's a positive multiplier effect, which would then taper down to, you know, consumers. But I think the initial impact now, or the initial positive impact now, should affect business consumers.
But it's not affecting consumers.
Well, that's
because it looks like new wine in old bottle. The bottle is, this wine skin is leaking.
Yeah, well,
so the effects and the oil prices, and thank goodness, oil is now, crude oil is around, all heading towards $80 a barrel, about $74. It looks like yesterday the oil price just kept moving every minute. I just stopped tracking it at some point. And so some folks say, hey, Bosin, it's now $74.83 per barrel. So we keep pumping this multi-billion-dollar oil revenue that Nigeria has in a wine skin that is leaking all over. That's what it looks like, because it's not getting to the man on the street.
It's not. And for the man on the street, it comes from a personal perspective. It's like, for me, prices are still stable. And if you look at, you know, our tracking so far when it comes to agricultural prices or commodity prices, they have been relatively stable. In fact, during the Easter period that we just, you know, witnessed so far, prices actually ramped up slightly. So those kinds of aspects are what we expect from consumers to, you know,